It's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about the most common causes of iatrogenic anterior open bites during aligner and Invisalign treatment. So hopefully you watched our one on posterior, now we're doing anterior. Let me go ahead and define that again. What I mean by this is patient didn't start with an anterior open bite. Patient started all normal, and one just happened. So this is what we're talking about today. So I say iatrogenic because we don't know the cause of it, right? But we're going to talk about some of the things that might be the most common causes and how to treat them. So this can happen. This can happen not only in Invisalign, but also can happen in braces, unlike the posterior open bite, which is very rare in braces. I do see this in braces all the time as well. Usually it should predict it, you know, like in the software. So if you didn't predict it in the software, then something kind of wonky might be going on. But more often in braces. But of course, please watch my previous video that I posted on anterior open bites, specifically the one that goes through the blog about anterior open bites, about all the things about airway, melon potty, tongue thrust, mouth breathing, habits. We go through all those things. So those can, of course, be a cause of it, but they should have presented before you started. So probably not. Other thing I like to look at, is it anterior? Is it unilateral? Is it bilateral? Because it could sometimes just be, you know, an issue with, like I said, habits or biting pens, biting pencils. I've seen a lot of things. But for the most part, it's usually just because you push the teeth too far forward and the teeth just start separating. It just wasn't possible. So maybe you need to add some IPR. Usually that's it. If you're not sure, it's always good to take a SAF x-ray and get some numbers, because that kind of shows you a little bit more if you kind of violated those angulations of the teeth. But it's usually a pretty easy fix. But if it was a habit, airway, tongue thrust, mouth breathing, you probably want to get that fixed, because if you don't address that, the chance of you retaining this case and having a good outcome long term is pretty low to none. Even with bonded retainers, even with good Essex retainers, it's going to outsmart you. That tongue is super strong. So, and habits are super strong. So you have to treat that concurrently or your case will completely unravel. Patient's going to be mad and you'll be retreating for free. So in any case, hopefully this was helpful. All right. Thank you.